Hello children, how are you? I hope you all are happy and healthy. So children, first of all, tell me, how many of you have a wristwatch at home? Or how many of you have ever seen a wristwatch? And how many of you know how to see time in a watch? Because there are so many things that we do in a whole day that are dependent upon time. Getting up in the morning, sleeping at night, taking bath, eating breakfast, going to school, or even playing games. All such things are done at their right time. So we must know how to see time in a watch. And we should be very punctual in our work. Because time is very precious. It never waits for anyone. Because time is very precious. It never waits for anyone. You know what happened once? Once there was a magic show. It was to start at 8 o'clock. There was one child who wanted to watch the show. But he could not reach in time. He reached at 9 o'clock. He was late. Thus, he could not watch the whole of the show. So tell me now, should we reach in time or should we get late? We should always reach in time. Otherwise, we will miss a lot of interesting things. Do you know, children? We all plan our day according to the time. We know that one whole day is divided into two parts, day and night. There is always night after day and a day after the night. Now, the night time is for sleeping, but the time of a day is for working and doing everything that we have to do. The daytime, the sun shines and gives us light. But at night, there is darkness all around. Can we do all type of work at night also? No, we can't. We cannot go to school. We cannot play outside. In the daytime also, the light of sun does not remain the same always. Thus, we divide the time of a day in four parts. First part is when the sun rises in the sky. It is called the morning. Second part is noon, when sun rises very high in the sky, right above our head. At this time, there is maximum light and the maximum heat of the whole day. We call it noon. The third part is afternoon. This is the time when the heat and light from the sun starts getting decreased. And the fourth part is evening, when sun starts setting down. We call it evening. Now, let's see how do we see time from a watch. Suppose we need to reach school at 8 o'clock. So how would you know that now it's 8 o'clock and now I should reach the school? Let's have a look at this clock. This is the instrument that we use to know the time. Everybody has a wall clock at home. And you all must have seen that it has two hands, or sometimes three hands. the little hand tells us about the hours. And the longer hand, it tells us about the minutes. And the fastest of them all, this thin red hand tells us about the seconds. Thus, we set all our routine according to the time and watch. What do we do first when we get up in the morning? We go to the washroom. We brush our teeth. We take a bath. After taking bath, we take our breakfast. And then we get ready for the school and go to school. In the school, we take all our classes. And then during recess period, we eat our food and also play games. After the recess period, we again study in our class. And when the school gets over, we return back to our home. So, have you ever noticed when you reach back home, the sun is quite above your head? That time is the time of noon or the afternoon. After reaching home, we change the uniform. And after washing hands, face, etc., we take the lunch. After taking rest for some time, we do our homework that we get from school. And then, when we notice that now it's evening time, then we get out to play with our friends. Wow! That's the best time. After playing, when the sun sets and it starts getting darker outside, then all the children return back to their homes. Then they spend some time watching TV, having dinner, and then they go to bed to sleep. All the chores that we talked about here make our daily routine. So children, have a look at your book, chapter 5. From here, you can see Sampada's routine. In the first picture, Sampada is awake now and is sitting on her bed. In the window, we can see the sun that says, "Wake up, wake up, it's morning time." Now, look at the second picture. Sampada is taking her breakfast. Before going to school, she takes her breakfast. In the third picture, what do you see? Oh, Sampada is reading a story from her book. And the whole class is listening to the story. So they all are studying in school. Now look at the next picture. Here, she is eating her lunch. Now, in the next picture, she is playing with her friends. So, that's her playtime. In the next picture, Sampada is again studying. That's her study time. And here, in this picture, she has gone to sleep in her bed. Look, outside the window. What can you see there? Do you see the sun? No. So what do you see? We see stars and moon. It means it is night. So we all should sleep. So children, did you notice? When sun rises in the sky, then all the stars and the moon get disappeared. And when the sun sets in the evening, after that, slowly we begin to see the moon and all the stars. Here we saw the routine of Sampada, which is just like your routine. We saw everything we do or that she does has a fixed time. So now answer a few of my questions. First is, when do you brush your teeth? In the evening, at noon, or in the morning? So tell me, when do you brush your teeth? The right answer is in the morning. We always brush our teeth in the morning. Now the next question. When do you go out to play? At noon, in the evening, or at night? So the answer will be in the evening. Okay. When do you take your breakfast? At night, in the evening, or in the morning? We all know that we take our breakfast in the morning. Now answer my last question, which is, when do you sleep? In the morning, at night, or in the evening? So what is the right answer? And the right answer is at night, because we all sleep at night. Night is for sleeping. Now from these pictures, select the activities that you do in the morning. Just look at the pictures and choose the activity that you do in the morning time. In the first picture, we see a child taking bath. Then a child studying. Then a child having lunch. And here we have another child brushing teeth. So out of these, which activities are done in the morning? Yes, taking bath and brushing teeth. Now, here, tick the activities that you do in the evening. Here again, the first picture is of a child taking bath. Next picture shows a few children playing with each other. The third picture has a boy going to school. And the last picture shows a boy sleeping in his bed. So what do you do in the evening out of these? We do not take bath in the evening. Yes, we do play in the evening. Oh, we do not go to school in the evening. That we do in the morning. And sleeping, that we do at night. So, in the evening, we play with our friends. So, the right answer is playing with friends. Now, tick the activities that you do in the daytime. Brushing teeth, going to the park, taking lunch, or taking bath. In the daytime, we go to the park and we also take lunch. Now, we need to tick the activities that you do at night. Sleeping, studying, sleeping, or going to school. No, at night, we only sleep. So, the right answer is sleeping. So children, here we saw the activities that we do at different times of the day. In the morning, at noon, or the afternoon, in the evening, and at night. Now, look at these pictures. What is going on in these pictures? In these pictures, we have a man who is making chapati with a rolling pin. A child eating chapati. A man lighting a fire. The man making a dough for chapati. Man pouring water in the flour. A man taking out flour from a container. We need to number these activities in sequence. So what do you think? Which picture should come first? Have you ever seen anyone making chapatis? What do we need to do first? We will arrange these pictures in sequence. That is, what is to be done first, and then what later, what after that, and so on. So, first thing first. Look at the picture carefully and tell me, which picture should come first? Which picture should be kept at number 1? Lighting fire, rolling with a pin, making dough, pouring water, eating chapati, or taking dry flour out of the container? Yes! First of all, we will need the dry flour to make the dough. So this picture should be given number 1. After this, we add water to it. First flour, then water. So which picture shows water? Yes, here. So this picture will be given number 2. Now tell me what next. Next, we will need to make the dough. So which picture shows the man making the dough? Here, this one. So we will write number 3 here. At number 1, we have taking out the flour. At number 1, we have the man taking out the flour. And at number 2, we have the man pouring water in it. And now, at number 3, we will have the man making the dough. Then, at number 4, now we need to make chapatis. So, do you see any rolling pin in the pictures? Someone making chapatis with a rolling pin? Yes, here. So here we will write number 4. Now what next? What should be done now? Now this chapati needs to be cooked. For that we will need a fire. Do we have the man lighting a fire somewhere? Yes, in this picture. So that will be our next picture. The picture number 5. And in the end, the chapati is ready to be eaten. We can eat it. So who is the one eating chapati here? Here, this little girl. She is eating chapati. So our next picture will be this. Number 6. Now, let's see another question. Look at these pictures and tell me, which activity will take longer? That is, which activity will take more time? Filling a bucket with water from a tap? Or filling a big drum with the water from a tap? Think and tell. In the first picture, we have a small bucket. And in the next picture, we have a big drum. So, which one will take longer to get fully filled? And yes, the right answer is the drum. Drum will take more time to fill because it is so big. Now look here. Here in these pictures, the first boy is going out by foot, that is walking. And in the next picture, the boy is riding a bicycle. So who will take longer? That is, who will take more time to reach? Yes, the boy who is walking will take more time because the cycle will move faster. Very good. Now, let us look at a few questions and try to find out their answers. The first question is, who will be the first in covering a given distance? A person by car, a person by cycle, or a person walking on feet? So the right answer is a person by car, because a car moves fastest than other. Next question is, which instrument is used to tell the time? Calendar, newspaper, or clock? Right answer is clock. In how many parts do we divide a day? We have talked about this in the chapter. If you have heard it, you will surely know. In how many parts we divide a day? 6, 4, 3, or 2? And the right answer is 4. We divide a day in 4 parts. Now answer another question. What shines in the sky at night? Have you ever seen the sky at night? If yes, then what did you see in the sky at night? Sun, fireflies, moon, or lightning? So what is the right answer? The right answer will be moon. We see moon at night. Now let us fill some blanks. In the daytime, we see dash in the sky. Light, darkness, or stars? In the daytime, we see light in the sky. What do we do at night? Eat, play, or sleep? And the right answer is we sleep at night. Now, let's match these activities with the time. When do we brush our teeth? When do we take bath? Or sleep? Or play? Or study? At night? In the evening? In the morning? Or in school? This you can do by yourself. And I hope that you all have understood it very well. And you will be able to do it. Thus, in today's chapter, we tried to understand the importance of time. We should do all our work in time. We should reach school in time, or we will miss many things. So we should do all the work in time. I hope from now you will do all your work in time and will never be late in doing anything. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.